Thanks for being here and good morning all. So the topic is going to be something at the molecular level. I'm sure you people had a coffee just now outside, so I assure that you're not going to we'll get it served, sir. Complaints again. We'll get it served here if you are awake after my talk. So the mitochondrial modulation is the heart of the matter is the title, which is going to be the outline about the global burden, progressive diabetes, cutting the risk of this metaflexibility is the new terminology what we talk about, and the early intervention, and of course meeting the unmet need with these mitochondrial modulators in our armamentarium for treatment. So we know diabetes and pre-diabetes prevalence in adults with the as high as about 11%, and the current estimate, we have about 75 million Indians with diabetes, and we are second to China. So we have moved on when it comes to the pathogenesis from the triumvirate to Omnius octate. All of us know that we're literally involving whatever the available systems for the pathogenesis of the hypoglycemia. And of course, we have been the glucose-centric approach, and the fallacies of these have been shown way back in UKPDS, in the VADT trials, all that, but targeting only the A1C below 7% is not going to help you, is not going to prevent your macrovascular complications. And this clearly talks about the typical thin fat Indian phenotype, where there is high prevalence of micro and macrovascular complications with young diabetics, and also increased burden of CV risk. And at early age, at least a decade early, our patients succumb to these complications. So, what is the reason? There is a progression in this pathogenesis. We are talking about today adiposity, the adipocytokines, oxidative stress damage, and the higher levels of glucagon and genetic factors. Of course, finally, the mitochondrial dysfunction is what we are proposing as a new mechanism in the pathogenesis. So let us look at this metabolic flexibility. Normally, as you can see here, the hyperplasia of adipocytes results in the chronic inflammation and results in an imbalance between the expression of the pro-inflammatory cytokines, which is one of the typical pathogenesis proposed in Indian context. And this now we are proposing the mitochondrial dysfunction is one of the key defects in this insulin and beta cell resistance, which ultimately acts upon the various systems resulting in the endothelial dysfunction and, of course, the RAS activation and the vascular complications. So we know the mitochondria is the kitchen of the cell, which releases ATP molecules, it fires literally, and this dysregulation in the switch therapy, because in the fed state and in the obesity or hyperglycemic state, there is a fuel switching, which is metaflexibility, is deranged, and that is what is the proposed mechanism. And this alternative switching of this metabolic fuel is lost during this chronic fed state and in the metabolic syndrome like obesity. And this happens across the organ systems, as you can very clearly see, the cardiovascular system, the skeletal muscle system, even in the pancreas at the level of pancreas. End of the day, there is a release lesser of ATP molecules, and this pushes the oxidative stress. So the alternative hypothesis, what we are talking about, is the mitochondrial dysfunction, which both in skeletal muscle and at the pancreatic level, there is a defective insulin secretion. And this long-term exposure of glucose and free fatty acids surpasses this adaptive threshold for ensuing the lipo and glucotoxicity, eventually resulting in the vascular complication. So this is what I was talking about, the switch between. Whenever there is an increased fatty entry or the fatty acid oxidation, the free fatty acid acylation, what we call, it results in the increased acetyl-CoA, and this oxidative stress and acetylation eventually results in the glucotoxicity, and the proposed mechanism is the mitochondrial dysfunction. So this substrate utilization reduces whenever there is a mitochondrial lipid oxidation enhances in the fed state, like in obesity or in metabolic syndrome, and this phosphorylation will result in the increased nitric oxide production, and eventually the macro and microvascular complications are resulted. And this mechanism is also now proposed for the erectile dysfunction, which we see as one of the microvascular complications in diabetes. And of course, this metabolic inflexibility with respect to the mitochondrial dysfunction has been proposed through various genetic factors, environmental factors, and eventually the beta cell function and insulin resistance, and is resulting in the complications of diabetes. So let us look at the unmet need now in our treatment. We know this age of this multimorbidity and continuum of cardiorenal metabolic syndrome is now proposed to be instigated by this mitochondrial dysfunction. This is again the lifestyle modification, which has shown that restricting the calories has got little impact on the long-term efficacy of this mitochondrial dysfunction and the advantages of this intermittent fasting. So there are no studies. In fact, there is a small study done which has shown that the persistence of exercise with the intermittent fasting will not reduce the microvascular complications. And the one other class of drug which is there now available is the TZDs, which can counter this to the PPAR pathway, where the only the glucotoxicity is not taken care, only the lipotoxicity is taken care. Again, there is an unmet need. Similarly, the newer class SGLT2s will accentuate lipolysis, and the non-HDLC component is increased, which is one of the markers for this toxicity of the, or the mitochondrial dysfunction. Non-HDL is one of the the markers for this inflexibility. So what are these mitochondrial modulators? They are the drugs which benefit patients by these new mechanisms that would make the system and the organ dysfunction, altering the hemodynamics. So they correct the metabolic dysfunction due to inappropriate or underutilization of the carbs, proteins, and lipid substrates, and they directly correct the metabolism defects in the liver, pancreas, and skeletal muscle to improve this insulin resistance and insulin sensitivity. And mitochondrial modulators directly improve cellular energetics by glucose and lipid disposal while improving the NO-mediated endothelial dysfunction. So basically, we are trying to look at the basic defect pathophysiological mechanisms at the level. And the ideal OAD with the mitochondrial modulator effect, what we want is should correct the mitochondrial dysfunction, the insulin resistance, and the insulin secretion, and eventually resulting in the reduction of the A1C and the CVD risk as a whole. And that is what we look at. Are there anything available now? Of course, there is only one class of drug which is available. And these novel mitochondrial modulators are the which targets and upregulates the mitochondrial energy transport chain. And that is what we look at. And eventually, improving the insulin sensitivity and correcting the glucose and improving the lipid profile. And of course, the other cardiovascular advantage. So there is one late stage clinical development, which is phase 2B, which is going on. And I'm one of the part of this study wherein these mitochondrial modulators, we're looking at these endpoints. And of course, it's not yet done, where we're looking at the A1C, the blood pressure, and the non-HDLC component, whether it improves or not. And that is what we're looking at. And there is only one group which is there. So finally, the unmet need for thin fat Indians, we know these two classes of drugs are there, the metformin and the SGLT2 for the people with moderate risk and a very high risk. But what about the high risk component, which we see in day in and day out in our OPD, where a diabetic patient more than 10 years without any target organ damage plus any other additional risk factors, for them, we are proposing mitochondrial modulators would try to correct the basic defect in this. And thank you very much for patient hearing. And I'm sure all of you are awake with the tea rather than my lecture. Thank you very much. And I need a bit to compensate for the time. We are running about 20 minutes late. Thank you very much for being here.